All right, so my name is Kelley Winfrey, and I am the coordinator of research and outreach at the Carrie Chapman Catt Center for Women in Politics at Iowa State University. I also teach in the Greenlee School of Journalism, where I teach classes in political campaigns. And my research interest is really about political communication and how it relates to gender. And today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about campaign communication and how you communicate during a campaign. And I'll start by saying, a campaign is communication. So this is really going to give you an overview of how you build a communications plan and how you start to execute that. So we'll start with the most important question is, why are you running for this office? Before you develop any content to your communication, you need to figure out who you are so that you can figure out what you're going to talk about. So why are you running for this office has to be a question that you can answer. If you knock on someone's door and they say, well, why are you running? And you don't have a clear answer, you're not going to win their vote. So you need to do some reflection about why you're running, what matters to you, what has driven you to this. And also, why running for this office? Because that is also an important question. If you want to solve federal taxes, then running for the city council doesn't make any sense. So you want to have a good argument, not just for why you're running, but for why you're running for that particular office. Another part of this analysis is what's called a SWOT analysis. And this is where you look at your strengths and weaknesses, opportunities and threats. Your strengths and weaknesses are the internal characteristics that you bring to the campaign. So the strengths might be that you're a strong communicator, that you're a good fundraiser. Maybe you have a personal experience with the healthcare system that informs your position. Those might be strengths. Weaknesses are the flip side of that. They are the things that maybe you lack as a candidate, maybe areas where you don't have a lot of experience, things that you're not quite as good as your opponent might be yet. Your opportunities and threats are related to the political context. So what's going on in your district, in your state, in your country, and how does that influence your campaign? So for example, if it's a blue wave year and you're running as a Democrat, that can help you. If you're a Republican, on the other hand, in a blue wave year, that's a threat to you. I think a really good example is to think about the presidential election in 2008. As the economic crisis came to a head shortly before the presidential election, the economic situation in the country became an opportunity for Obama and a threat to McCain. So think about what's going on in the world around you and how that will influence your campaign. So this is really kind of an assessment and a brainstorming part. Now, once you've done that, you can start to think about what you're going to put in your communication content. So what is your message? One big picture thing to think about is, what is your core message and what are the values that you hope to communicate and that you're campaigning for? So in political campaigns, you might hear things like unity, equality, change, these big picture ideas that are the umbrella for which cover the rest of your issues. So it's the larger theme. When you think about campaign slogans, those usually reflect an overarching theme and some sort of values that's driving that campaign. You also want to think about, what are your core issues and what is your rationale for those issues? So what issues do you care about? Why do you care about them? And why do you have a solution to this? So why are you the person to address this issue? You don't want to have too many issues, because if you're talking about 10 different issues, voters aren't going to really know you for anything. So it's a good idea to come up with two or three that you really make central to your campaign, and those are what you focus a lot of your communication on. As you think about those issues, you also want to think about what matters to voters. So there might be an issue that's really important to you as a candidate, but is it really something that your voters care about? So you either have to decide how to make your voters care about that issue, or even though that might be something that you do when elected, isn't a central part of your campaign. The third part of your content has to do with who you are. So you want to think about the biographical information that you're going to include in your communication. This could be positions that you've held, jobs you've had, it could be education, it could be professional experience, it could be personal experience. Personal experience can be really compelling. A lot of times when we run for office, we run because of something we see happening in our day-to-day lives. So bringing in that personal experience can be a really compelling part of your communication. So you've done a self-assessment, you've thought about kind of what the content is, what the main themes are, what your main ideas are. You can start to map out your communication. And so here we have a message box, and this is a way to think about what you're going to say and what your opponent might say. It's important to think about both of those things because a campaign is a conversation. It's a conversation between you and your opponent and the voters. And so you want to think about what your opponent's message is likely to be so that you can respond appropriately or inoculate voters against attacks that might be made. So mapping this out as you are developing your communication plan will help you execute a more successful campaign. So you think about what you will say about yourself. And that's a lot of what we've talked about so far is what are your strengths? What are your core messages? What are your issues? What are your qualifications? You also want to think about what your opponent will say about you. So that might be thinking back to what your weaknesses are, what your threats are. Where might you have vulnerabilities that they would capitalize on in their communications? You want to think about what you will say about your opponent. That doesn't mean you have to make nasty attacks. That's not what this is. But in order to demonstrate that you are the person that people should vote for, because this is a competition, you need to be able to say, this is why I'm better than him or her. So you need to know what issues maybe you disagree with them on, what qualifications they do or don't have that make them not as good of a candidate as you. And also think about what your opponent's gonna say about his or herself. So what issues are they likely to campaign on? So you kind of do that self-assessment and that SWOT analysis for your opponent so you can think through what their messages are likely to be. A campaign is a lot like a game of chess. So you make a move, your opponent makes a move. You want to try to think about what those moves might be in advance so you know how you're going to respond or you can preempt them in some way. So this helps you organize your big picture communications plan. So now we can look at the stump speech, which is one of the most important parts of your campaign. This is a speech that you repeat often, oftentimes endlessly. If you follow candidates during the presidential cycle as they go around the state, you'll hear basically the same speech at every stop. They might have a long version and they might have a short version. And it might be tailored slightly based on the audience that you're talking to, right? If you're talking to teachers versus farmers, you might use some different examples. But the core of that speech is the same in all contexts. This speech, you might use at events, and it might also be a version of your door knocking speech, so your elevator pitch. So you might have a 10-minute speech and a 90-second speech, but the core of that's gonna be the same. The things that you need to make sure to include in this speech is who you are. If they don't know your name, they're not gonna vote for you. The office that you're running for, oftentimes we forget that. We say, hi, I'm Kelley, I'm running for office. You need to make sure you know that they know what office you're running for. Explain why you're running, explain why you're qualified, and then emphasize your core message and theme. So back to that overarching theme. Depending on how long your speech is, you might go into more or less detail on the issues and how you're gonna address those issues, but the shell of this will be the same across all contexts. The last thing that's really important is that you should make an ask. You wanna get people involved in your campaign. The ask could be something like, will you read my palm card? It could be, will you vote for me? It could be, will you come to this event? Or will you donate money? But you wanna give them a stake in your campaign. So you wanna ask them to participate in some way. And that helps that interactive quality of campaigning that I was really famous for is that retail politics. So we wanna have that one-on-one contact and we wanna engage the voters. So your stump speech, which you might call your elevator pitch, depending on how you're doing it, will help you figure out a lot of your other communication. Because that stump speech is going to have your core message, your core value, your key issues, that can be used as a starting point to develop a whole lot more communication. So as I mentioned at the beginning, there are a lot of different types of communication in a campaign. So there's earned media, which is basically when you get the news media to do a story about you. That could be by releasing, for doing press releases, it might be hosting an event, it might be issuing a policy position, or even using social media in a way that would get the attention of news media. Earned media is great because it's a third-party source, right? It's somebody else talking about your policy, not just you, and that can be very beneficial. The bulk of a campaign is paid media, and this is media that you pay for, and it includes everything from advertising, like on television or radio or social media, to direct mail, to yard signs, but any sort of communication that you pay to get your message out to voters. This matters a lot because you get to control the content of this message. Unlike earned media, you don't know how much time they're going to give you. You don't know what they're going to say about your policy paper. In paid media, you can decide exactly what the message is and how to present it. You can also target it to specific audiences. So whether it be choosing when and what media market to run a TV ad, or who to send direct mail pieces to, you can really tailor your message to voters so that you're reaching them where they're at. And then the third is in person. And this is what we talked about, includes things like door knocking or your stump speech at events, even phone calls. But this is that sort of unmediated retail politics that can be very important in certain races. If you are running in a race where you can walk your voting area, then in-person communication is something you want to make a key part of your campaign, because nothing reaches a voter more than you knocking on their door and talking to them one-on-one. That's not always possible. If you're running a statewide campaign, you're not going to be able to do that, so you're going to use more of the paid media options. But in-person is free as long as you are out there going door to door. It takes time and energy, but it doesn't cost you much money to do that. So to summarize the big picture, as you develop your communication plan, you want to make sure that you're being strategic. You want to think through, what are your strengths and weaknesses? How is this going to play out through the course of the campaign as you consider your opponent, or maybe you have multiple opponents? And you want to make sure that all the communication that you put out there matters, that it's strategic. So there shouldn't be a Facebook post that has nothing to do with your campaign. Everything needs to have a reason. Sometimes that reason is to help voters see who you are as a person. Sometimes it's to put specific policy issues out there, but it all needs to be part of that same theme. Because if you have too many different messages going on, people don't know you for something. And you want people to say, oh, I know that Kelley stands for this. This is the issues that she cares about. That will help them remember you on election day. Also, make sure that you target your message to winnable voters. And there are a lot of different winnable voters. There's always going to be a segment of voters that are not going to vote for you because of your political party. There are going to be voters that are always going to vote for you because of your political party. And then there's a lot of other people. So you want to think about which of those groups are winnable for you, and how do you talk to them? What issues matter to them? How do they think about those issues? So that you can tailor your communication in a way that helps them understand why you are a good candidate and what you bring to the table. You also want to, related, make that message relevant to your audience. So education is one of those issues that everybody says is important. The reasons that it's important to a 40-year-old mother of three might be different than the reason it's important to a 20-year-old single man. That doesn't mean that you can't talk to them about the same issue, but the examples that you use, the parts of that you focus on, are going to be different. And last, and I'd say most importantly, is your message needs to be clear and memorable. So again, if you have too many messages, talking about too many issues or too many themes, then it's hard for people to remember what it is you stand for. So pick messages that are consistent so that people know this is what you are. I think of Barack Obama's campaign was about hope and change, right? That's something that we'll probably remember for a very long time because it was so clear that that was the central theme of his campaign. So not that we're all going to be Barack Obama, you know, running for whatever office, but think about that as a good example of how you would use communication. And last but not least, I want to refer you to a few additional resources. As I said, most of what you do in a campaign is communicating. So at the Carrie Chapman Catt Center for Women in Politics, where I work, we host the Ready to Run Iowa Campaign Training School. And we also have materials online from that school. So you can look back at resources. There are worksheets, there are PowerPoints that you can look back at to get some more guidance, focusing on different things. So maybe working with the news media or social media strategy. We also host the Archive of Women's Political Communication, which is an online database of women's speeches and television ads, so you can look at examples from other candidates and maybe get ideas of what might work for you. The Center for American Women in Politics at Rutgers University also has a large amount of information on their website for people, particularly women, that are interested in running for office. The Barbara Lee Foundation does research related to women candidates and gives some does reports that give some tips about what women might want to think about as they develop their campaign messaging. And then the last one is the textbook I use for my political campaigns class. It takes a practitioner's point of view from a campaign strategist and tells you all the different components of communication and gives some best practices as well. So it's a good resource that you could buy used and kind of get an overview of what's going on. So I'll end there to say, remember to be strategic in your communication and to think about how you can best tell voters why you are the best candidate for this office. Thank you.